Hey everybody. So today I want to make a video on connecting Salesforce to OpenAI, like ChatGPT. I think that a lot of people don't understand exactly how easy it is to connect these two platforms and what you can do with them once you have them connected. So I just want to do this as a general overview. Very first, why I want to use ChatGPT 4.0 in this particular instance is very specifically. So Salesforce is very active and involved in the open source community and open source AI community, and they have their own Hugging Face, and they do a lot of things on Hugging Face. One of the things that they have is their own LLM leaderboard for CRM, which is performance based, and it's, you know, put out and maintained by Salesforce specifically by them. And you can see by their own metrics, GPT 4.0, I mean, it clocks every other model that is out there right now with regards towards Salesforce specifically, and that includes Salesforce's own AI models. And that's very important within this to me, in that, like, I see a lot of models come out and a lot of companies that are, like, advertising that their own, you know, their own models for these platforms and things like that, but Salesforce's own model gets beat by GPT 4.0 in Salesforce by Salesforce's own metrics. Just pointing that out overall. But so in order to connect this, so next step, and it's very simple. So I have this Google Colab notebook, and I'll link this Colab notebook in the description of this video. I don't want to run this Colab notebook live within here because it's just too many credentials, and then I don't want to erase all the credentials within this, and I don't want to deal with credential issues flat out. But the very first thing and the biggest thing that this relies on is a package that's called Simple Salesforce. And so I'll just demonstrate this for you, and I'll showcase this for you here real quick as well. This is from GitHub, and then so Simple Salesforce is put out by a company, Simple Salesforce. They have it released as an Apache 2.0 license, which means it's open source, free to everyone. You can see that there's hundreds of contributors. It's got like 1,600 stars, a bunch of forks, you know, like, so this is huge. I didn't just create this, right? And then so Simple Salesforce, it's very simple and very straightforward. It allows you to connect to your Salesforce environment via Python, which is what we want to do in this instance, and then all we need to do in this instance. And it gives you two login methods that you can use, the straightforward method of just via like your credentials, as you can see via the Colab notebook that we have here. So username, password, and security token, or you can use client ID and client secret, and then go through and authenticate that way. So once you're authenticated within the platform, you have all of your credentials and you have everything set up within this, you need your Salesforce credentials and your OpenAI credentials. Pass those over. And then in this instance, once you have it all set up, we're doing this. This particular function is designed to insert a lead into Salesforce. And then so you can see first name, last name, company, and email. And then you can see that we'll call essentially GPT 4.0 mini in this instance. And then we're going to have it generate a lead record with first name, last name, company, and email. You can see though, if you're paying attention to this code, in this instance, it is set to max tokens of 50. So it's going to have, it's going to cut off. In this instance, you would want to increase this maybe to, let's say, like 200. And then that would be probably like more realistic. Maybe you want like, and just making sure that it's not going to cut off and making sure that's not going to put extraneous details as well, right? And then so one of the things that you do want to, you will want to play around with this. And then you can see even going to their own leaderboard on Salesforce here, right? That it's not going to, like, these scores, like it's a 3.1, 2.94, like these are out of 5, right? So it's not it could do it better. Like, it's a C student when it comes to these things. And then so just giving it a general prompt, like generate a lead record with first name, last name, company, and email. It's generally going to struggle a little bit with that, right? Like, you want to give it more detail, and you're going to put probably some more parsing into this. And then you can see I do have a little bit of parsing in here, but you're gonna want to parse out more, and then just up front, so this is essentially parsing out the information that the model spits out, and then we're gonna insert that into Salesforce, and then we print that, and then we print insert lead, and then if you just let this go, like, I can almost guarantee you're going to have data that you don't want into your system, right? So you don't want to just let this go without human oversight. I would never do that. Like you want that, like you can batch it if you want, but then you would want to check within batches overall. But so within this, this is showcasing leads. You can change this logic, right? Opportunities, contacts, whatever accounts, whatever you want to do. And then this gives you very straightforward and simple access. You can see it's just two things. It's Python, and then it's all credentials, right? Once you have your credentials, then it's just building out your function, and then it's just calling the OpenAI via API like you normally would in any other instance. And that's literally all you need to do to connect Salesforce to OpenAI. Again, like you will want to put in work here on this prompt, right? Like I'm telling, like up front, like the very first thing that up front that this is going to error on is around here, and then cleaning this up more, and then so putting on more prompting and then more parsing would be good within this instance, is like the first two things and instances to troubleshoot within this. But you can see overall, this gives you a head start and at least a place to experiment. I would set this up first in like your sandbox org. I have it like I have a developer org that I have connected to that I've been playing around with specifically. So however you want to set up and play with that, I'll leave that up to you. But if you like this type of content, please like and subscribe. Thank you very much.